So you're looking to getting into multi-streaming, but you don't want to use a service like Mobcrush or Restream, or you're just looking for a free option. Today I've got you. Not only am I going to show you an OBS plugin that does exactly what those platforms do for free, but it also does more, like custom bitrate to different platforms and custom resolutions to make sure that you match within the transcoding options that they need. Let's get into it. Before we get into today's video, I just want to say thank you for stopping by. My name is Brandon, and I'm here to improve the streaming experience not only for you, but also for your viewers. If you like this video, make sure you hit it with a thumbs up to help it out in the YouTube algorithm. Also, come check me out on stream. I stream on my personal YouTube channel. The link for that's in the description, and on Twitch, Monday, Wednesday, and Friday at 9 p.m. Eastern. And with that out of the way, let's talk about how you can get multi-streaming for free with this amazing plugin. And before somebody asks it in the description, no, Kevin, it doesn't work for Streamlabs OBS. Only OBS. Consider upgrading to OBS. To get the plugin for OBS, make sure you go ahead and check the description for the link, or just go ahead and Google multiple RTMP outputs for OBS. Should be one of the first things that pops up. Once you get onto the page, you're going to go over to the right side of the screen and click go to download. And as we're jumping over here, I just want to go ahead and say, make sure that you have at least OBS version 26, because that's what this plugin needs to be able to work. Once you get over onto the GitHub page to download the package, make sure you go ahead and check for the latest release. For me, it was 2.6.1 that was released a couple of weeks ago. And we're going to go ahead and download the zip file and go ahead and save it somewhere where we can access it. Once you've downloaded it, go ahead and extract this folder. And then inside the folder, you're gonna go ahead and run the application that is the OBS multi RTMP setup. Caveat, make sure that you have OBS closed when you run this, otherwise it won't install. Once you've got that installed, go ahead and open OBS and you're going to see a multiple output window pop up somewhere onto your dashboard. Go ahead and move it and resize it to where it's easy for you. If not, make sure you go under View and Docs and go ahead and turn on multiple output just in case it didn't activate when you first launched it. Now to get this set up, you're going to need to click Add New Target and it's going to ask you a few things like enter in the name that you want to name this. So for this example, we're going to go ahead and name this Twitch. Even though I already have one set up, I'll just call this one Twitch 2. For the RTMP server and key, make sure you go ahead and check the website specifically for your platform, like Twitch, Facebook, YouTube, any of those, and make sure you grab the ones that are specific for the platform. Remember to not share your key with anyone. Be very careful when you open this while streaming because it doesn't block it out. So people will be able to see your stream key on stream if you have this window open and that's what's being captured. So just be careful. So for right now, I'm just going to type in RTMP and key, and then we'll go ahead and move down to the video settings. From here, you're going to be able to choose your encoder of choice. For example, if you're using NVENC on an NVIDIA card or AMF from a Radeon card, or you just want to use X264, you can choose it from here. Now know that this can be different from your main encoder that's being streamed from the actual program. For right now, we're going to go ahead and choose X264 because it is different from my main encoder, which is NVENC that I'm using on my 2060 Super. From here, you're also able to go ahead and choose your resolution. Now, if you leave it blank, it'll go ahead and give you what OBS settings you have in your settings, but you can go ahead and manually type in something like 720p, and then you can change your bit rate. For example, I'll go ahead and make this 3500. And keyframes, make sure they're always on 2. Most of your platforms require that you have 2 or suggest 2, so I'll just make sure you go that way. For the audio settings, you probably don't need to change any of these, but there are the options if you want to use a different FFmpeg encoder. Choose a mixer ID and a different bit rate if you'd like to do that. Once you have everything set up, you'll go ahead and click OK, and you'll see that it's popped up and populated inside the list that you can choose to go live from. Now, just to go ahead and let you know, for this to work, you have to go ahead and go live directly from OBS. So you have to actually go over to your controls and click start streaming from OBS to be streaming to a source and then go back to multiple output and click start. It will not start streaming unless you are already streaming from the base OBS program. So on the screen right now are two clips. One on the right is going to be my stream where I was on Twitch, and the one on the left is where I was streaming on YouTube at the same time doing an interview this past Friday on my stream. And you can see that they're really close in quality, but they're actually completely different resolutions and bit rates. YouTube is actually getting 30K bitrate, and Twitch is only getting 6,000 bitrate. Both of them had transcoding active, and they were working on completely different encoders. The YouTube stream was on NVENC, and the Twitch stream was on X264. Now that all that's installed and set up, I just want to go ahead and let you know of a few things you need to consider. Number one, depending on your graphics card, you might not be able to encode more than one video stream at a time. Make sure you go ahead and check with your model and see if the encoder built on your graphics card, whether it be an AMD card or an NVIDIA card, supports multiple out streams. Some older cards, like the 600 or 700 series for NVIDIA, maybe only support one output stream, whereas the newer cards support multiple. So make sure you check with the manufacturer of your card so that you know you can do these. If you're going to use X264, make sure you have a processor, because that's what it actually encodes with. Make sure you have a processor that can handle the power, game, as well as being able to use OBS. Depending on what you're doing, you could quickly max out your CPU, hurting your stream, your gameplay performance, as well as just maybe even pushing your heat too far on the system. So make sure you have a system that's built and done well for this. If you don't have a rig like that, go ahead and consider using something like Restream or Mobcrush to be able to send your feed to and let them go ahead and split that feed out on their end. You're only sending one signal, and they're going to send it to all of the platforms that you choose to send it to after that. And that'll bring us to the end of the video. If you're looking for more tips and tricks, check out this playlist over here for a bunch of videos to help you out on your stream. And if you're looking for a capture card under $40 that was absolutely amazing, check out this video right here. I'm Brandon, and welcome to the darkness. We'll catch you next time.